Testing. And we are live again. Testing 1, 2, 3. Check. All right. Here we are, everyone. So that is interesting. I had a little bit of an issue with good. You could hear me. Excellent. Yeah, that was awfully interesting. Man, my background is awfully bright. Let's do a couple of things. Contrast, I think the contrast, maybe it's the intensity. There we go. Something like that. Perfect. We're back. All right. Audio and video quality is there. Good. Should have combed my hair a little bit better. How is everyone doing tonight? We're going to get started with one of those bad boys right there.
All right. It is official. Hello, everyone.
And I need
Welcome
to pause
back.
It. Okay. That was interesting. Okay, so I apologize about the technical difficulties that we got started with, but thank you all for coming to the new stream. That was weird. I went live and I saw the video working and the microphone was DEAD. Oh, Renee Sanchez, man. How did you know? So tonight we're going to have let me do a proper hello, everyone. One of those, and I hope you're all doing well. So, Mr. Rock from Toronto, hello. Greetings from New Jersey. Grandpa Joe, Steve Hale from the UK, hello, hello. Everyone could see me and hear me. Good. So, that's good. That is good news. I think the internet is broken. There seems to be too many people. I think the service providers, when COVID hit, they probably were not prepared for the amount of traffic that came their way. Susie Cherry, hello. Fred from Michigan. Gary from Oregon. Who else do we have here? Great Vanzini. Little Rody. Rob S. Guitar Fever. Mark says, congratulations on your new guitar. How are things over there? Things are okay. Things have always kind of felt normal. I say that compared to the news. Okay. Just to be clear. Of course, it's, a lot of home quarantine. But it's, normal, relatively speaking, because, you know, when you turn the news on, it's, breaking news, you know, that type of thing. John Pendergast from Austin, Texas. So yeah, tonight I have something new, exciting, and special for you, like I always have. Mr. Rock says, can't wait to open US. Yeah, I think they're now just starting to open industry. I know, and also I have friends in different states, and a buddy of mine who lives on the West Coast was telling me they opened restaurants now, but they could only like go 50% capacity, stuff like that. So I think the social distance is the new norm, where, you know, you just can't have a massive, wall-to-wall capacity, which I think is going to affect, you know, stuff that has high capacity like NAMM or Summer NAMM. I know Summer NAMM is canceled. I believe Gear Fest is canceled. That's what I heard. That's not official, but I did hear that it was canceled. I wouldn't be surprised if Winter NAMM 2021 is canceled. Sporting events, concerts, anything large, public gatherings, I think is going to be affected by this. Aiden Elliott from Pennsylvania. Hello, Aiden. How are you? One of those right there. So, John, tell me again. You said everything is pretty much open here. It's concerning. John, tell me again. Where are you from? I'm curious to know. 30% capacity in Delaware. Okay. I think they're slowly starting to get things open. I heard PRS Guitars was open. Or at least at some, maybe some limited capacity. Gary says, I work for a university, so I won't be going back to work for at least a month working virtually now. I suspect, so Ian, that's what I heard. I don't know that to be a fact. No one from Sweetwater told me that. But somebody that's making videos for the virtual Gear Fest told me that. So I guess that's a pretty good indicator, right? And that person's not a YouTuber, by the way. They're professional. Not to say I'm not professional, but all they do, they're not like a YouTuber company. They just do professional videos and stuff like that. Professional marketing agency. James, hello. Texas is 25%, but the mayor of San Antonio loves his power. Gotcha. Dan Event J says, I'm not optimistic about opening up at all. Suspect we'll see an alarming spike, a second wave. That Dan Event J, I'm thinking the same. In fact, my concerns are probably a little different than most people's concerns. If you're curious to know what my concerns are, I'm happy to share them with you. I don't want to scare anyone. I don't want to be like a news channel. And by the way, just to be clear, I am not saying that the news is bad. I'm not saying the news is fake. I'm just saying that the news has a story to sell. So, you know, everything sounds huge. That's why I like NPR news, because it's like that 10-10 wins monotone. Just give me the facts. That's kind of like what I like, NPR, you know, the boring news. So yeah, the thing that worries me is, the rate at which they're printing money. James Shackelford asked, is there going to be a Summer NAMM? No, Summer NAMM was canceled. That was officially canceled. Loose Cannon, hello. Yeah, so my concern is the rate at which they're printing money. And, you know, anytime, you know, it's like equity or options or stocks or bonds or whatever it is. The more you print, the less valuable they become, right? Currency can be devalued. And that's, yeah, Fezla just said inflation. Here we come. Currency could be devalued. And if you think COVID put our economy on the knees, wait till you see what the devaluation of a dollar could do to an economy, right? So that's what I'm hoping won't come to be. Wendell says, don't worry about the money printing. Please share with me why. I'd love to know your perspective on that. Adam D, hello. Stuff is already going up. Yep. BB Mate said deficits don't matter, I thought. James says it's going to take years to dig out of this mess. Yeah, it's interesting, though. Like Great Van Zini said, stuff is already going up. I've noticed that as well, in terms of one would naturally think, oh, the economy isn't doing well. You're going to see all these great deals. And where I have been seeing deals is like online clothing retailers, like my family buying some clothes online, 60% discounts, 50% discounts on things. Because you have to remember, clothes are marked up crazy. DR Guitars, hello. James Shackelford said, did you hear the House agreed to a $3 trillion deal, which may mean another round of stimulus? I did hear that. I didn't know if it was put into place, but that also affects, could positively affect people that have a mortgage and could negatively affect people that have tenants and that sort of thing. So there's interest. These are interesting times. Let's put it like that. Wendell says food prices have gone up. Yes, they have. My wife, who does the bulk of the shopping, sometimes I go, but my wife does the bulk. The food bill has been substantially more. So you think we're married for 20 years, and let's say you use a sample set of the last 5 years. It's been very consistent of what the grocery bill looks like. It's easily up substantially more every time. Great Van Zini says still has to pass the Senate and be signed off. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, food is going to be more expensive. Will this destroy the guitar industry? RXG, thank you for bringing us back on topic. I think we will see some effect in the industry. I think, well, let's put it like this. Macy's just filed for bankruptcy, brick and mortar. I think it's going to affect brick and mortar, mom and pop shops, right? That can open to sell their stuff. I think this will ultimately affect, you have to remember an economy, the underlying common denominator of economy is not only GDP, but it's people feeling happy and going out and spending money, right? And I think people are probably nervous to go out and spend money, especially the unemployment rate is an all-time high. That doesn't make people happy, nor does it make people want to spend money. I think the stimulus checks put a Band-Aid on things. You know, it's like when you take, when you have the flu and you take Tamiflu, it makes you feel a little bit better, but it doesn't get rid of the flu, right? I think the stimulus check was like giving everyone a dose of Tamiflu because it doesn't solve the problems. Amanda Coombs, hello. And when the stimulus goes away and the problems still exist, I think that's when you're going to start seeing prices of guitars drop for people that need the money. So sad for the seller, good for the buyer, I guess. Mr. Rock said will be a shortage on let's call it imported guitars. Absolutely. And also there is a little bit of a trend that we're seeing a lot of out of stock stuff, because you have to remember, and I speak for the US specifically, because I don't know every market, so I'm going to generalize just for the US. The US market is heavily dependent on a lot of imported merchandise. And you know, there's obviously this, you know, borders have been closed, that delays things coming in. So yeah, I think that will be have definitely an effect. The question is, when does this all occur, right? I think when stimulus money goes away, we have an event, right, where people start to unload stuff. If the unemployment rate remains as high as it is. And I also think that, you know, you have inflation. You also have to bear in mind supply and demand. If you're a guitar store and you're not getting inventory, I don't know if you want to blow out what you have, because then you'll have empty shelves, right? So there's this very weird dynamic that's occurring right now where I don't know if there's a lot of people sitting on a lot of inventory, right? Brian from Oregon says, every country in the world is in the same boat. Absolutely. Absolutely. I know, like, even in some other countries, folks I know from other countries, they're also printing money, right? I do it every time. Chad from Boston. to one of my longtime favorite YouTube friends, have a beer and a stellar weekend. Chad, thank you so much. And by the way, folks, Chad from Boston, wonderful human being, great YouTube channel, passionate about the gear like we are. So you should go check out his channel as well. And Chad, you're always here and I appreciate that. So thank you. And I hope you and your family are all doing well. Peyote Pete says the end of Chipsons. You know, I always wondered, do you even need a Chipson, right? You look at those new Epiphones, they're priced right. They're made by Gibson. They have a warranty. It's like, I don't know. Do you even need a Chipson anymore, right? I think, you know, I don't know. I'm just reading the comments. What's the new guitar? The new guitar, we're going to talk about that in about 5 minutes. Do you think all concerts should stay canceled? Well, they just canceled Broadway in New York City till I think it was September. Think about that. I mean, that's, Manhattan is a tiny little island. And they just canceled Broadway. Do you know how much money Broadway brings in? Not just from the tickets of Broadway, but the restaurants, the parking, the everything that is tied to Broadway. It's the economy's going to take a massive hit if it hasn't already. I think we haven't seen the worst of it, to be honest with you. And again, I'm talking purely economy. I know, hopefully, we've seen the worst of the illnesses and the health concern. I think there probably will be another spike because, you know, there's no vaccine. If people aren't socially responsible, there could be a spike. But I think the economy is, that's kind of what keeps me up at night is the economy, right? Because, you know, it's, it could affect everybody, right? Wendell Sexton says, USA is a consumer economy, paycheck to paycheck, households are the engine. Yeah, absolutely. And I would say, and I'm generalizing here, America owes money, right? I mean, our economy, our government owes money. And I think we live in a world of debt. I don't know if that's true for all parts of Earth, but certainly in America, you know, people buy cars on debt, homes on debt, credit card debt. If I were to guess without being in the financial industry, I'd probably guess that the average American has $10,000 of credit card debt, right? And then when you lose your job and all that occurs, it's tragic. I think the stimulus also gives leniency towards paying some of that debt, I think. I have been getting a lot of emails from banks, credit card companies. You know, every day I wake up to at least five emails of my car insurance sent me an email of, oh, we're taking 30% off of your bill. We're refunding 30% of your bill for the last couple of months. Like I see a lot of companies are doing the right thing, which is really nice to see that. In fact, I heard through a very good friend of mine who has a good friend of his that does collections for a big electrical company. And he told me that they're not collecting money, right? You know, it's okay if you can't pay the bill right now, which is really, you know, not good for the company, of course, because that's revenue. But it's nice to see that, you know, there's big business compassion for the people that are in hard times right now, which is nice to see. Will airline travel go sky high? Well, there was some reports of some airlines that said, we'll block out the middle seats. And then people were tweeting pictures of full sold out flights, right? That was in the news. That's pretty tragic, actually. And then I guess the airline responded that our goal is to have the middle seats blocked out. And it's like, yeah, that's not what your CEO said. He said, that's what we're doing. He didn't say, this is our goal. So we're going to see a lot of interesting things ahead of us. Anyway, we've been talking about the economy for 17 minutes. So my apologies. Hey, at least we didn't get political. We're just being economical, but not political. You know what? This thing affects all of us. And I think it's actually good, healthy conversation where we could help talk about these things, educate each other on these things, because you have to remember, I learned from you all the same way you learned from me, right? That's what makes this community awesome. Metal makes me crazy, says Delta just retired their Boeing 777s. They're going with Airbus. Boeing may fold if they don't start selling planes. Unless they get, well, you have to remember too, Boeing is also a defense contractor. They don't just make commercial planes. They do commercial. I don't know what like fighter jets, but they're also in the defense contract business. So I don't know. I don't know if they'll be that affected. Yes. Sorry about that. So let me see. Okay, so let's talk about guitars. Okay. So what I have behind me, let's unbox it and then we'll talk about it. So very excited about this. Let's go through it. By the way, this box is very heavy. Can you hear me okay when I walk away? Let me raise that volume on the microphone. Testing, testing. Okay, that should be better. Okay, very heavy box. This is packed like a tank, so I'm going to put it on its side and slide it out. And what I'm going to do here is put this right up over here. And this is a NAGS. Now, what's really exciting is, let me come down over here. What's really exciting about this is I've never played a NAGS. And for those that don't know, Joe NAGS, and he's co-owner in NAGS, okay, along with another gentleman, which I'll talk about in a few minutes, worked at PRS for many years. And he was, you know, had a pretty significant role there. So I'll put all the links in the description. And I think it was 2009, started his own guitar company called NAGS. Very high-end stuff, very quality USA-made stuff. And got artists like Steve Stevens playing his guitars. And I'm a big Steve Stevens fan, actually. So that's what we're going to check out. No, NAGS is made in Maryland, just like PRS Guitars, Maryland. Maryland, USA, Maryland-based company. Okay. You ready? We're going to do a proper unboxing here. You're going to see it the same time I'm going to see it. You ready? In fact, you're going to see it first. Okay. Not much to see because it's covered. Wow. That is a pretty guitar. I am going to tip it over and hopefully I don't drop it over, but I want to give you the proper visual. So I got to take it out. Nice case, by the way. This is a fit case. When I take the guitar out, I'll show you the case. Let me do this. Let me seal this up, put it on the floor, and then I'll take it out. So, I'm just going to hold it there for a second so you could see what's going on over here. Look at the back. And a nice NAG sticker over here. Even take my ring off. Let me stand up and give you a nice close-up of what's going on here. I love that, like, Honeyburst Goto tuners, locking tuners on those Klusen style. I actually never saw that before. That's interesting. It's like the vintage Klussen style, but they're Goto locking tuners. Nice flamed maple tinted back. Love the neck joint. Comes to like a little bit of a V right over here. So what this here is, and I think this is their own proprietary, is this little plate. This is on a pivot. So it's on here with these, I guess, like a bolt that goes through. So it rocks on the bolt. I don't know how many springs. Let me give it the old... I'm gonna tune it up. Let me take this off too. I don't want this banging around over here. And let me see what else is in the case. Oh, a bunch of stuff. Okay, I'm gonna show you what's in the case after I tune this bad boy up. Sorry, I didn't mean to have my back turned to you. This is actually red. It looks red in the camera. So let me give you some spec on here. So this guitar in particular, so I'm giving you general spec on this model. This one here is the Severn. And just so you know, the guitars are named after, I think, lakes or native Indian river names across North America, okay? And I started mentioning earlier, so Joe Nags is the luthier, and his owner is Peter Wolf. and spent some time on the phone with Peter Wolf. Just a very, very nice person to speak with. You know, I guess he runs the business side of the house. Just a very, again, nice person. We were talking about the guitars, and you know, he wanted to send this over to, you know, he and I were talking. This is a loaner guitar, by the way, just to be clear. And we were talking about, you know, covering some Nags, and just a nice guy. Overall, just a nice guy. So he's the other half of Nags. They're partners, at least to my understanding. And this one here is the Severn, okay? And the spec on the Severn is... semi-gloss finish, trem, hardtail, or T-tank, alder body, set rock, maple neck, opaque finish, 25 and a half inch scale, 22 frets, 8.5 inch fingerboard radius, neck shape, they call it the 61, rock maple neck. This is rosewood for USA only, Macassar ebony, ebony or curly maple, depending on what it is. This one actually looks like Macassar ebony. If it's rosewood, it's awfully dark. I would say this is Macassar ebony, just based on what it looks like to me. Nag circle with star. Oh, this is just the circles. I don't see a star. Yeah, just circles. And let's see what else we have here. The body could be swamp ash, alder, mahogany. Again, I'm not exactly sure. This isn't the official review. But I will say it's a very comfortable weight. Four springs in the back, someone had asked in the comments. You could see that back there. Those silver things are four screws. I love the tinted flame maple neck. How is that coming across? Does that sound okay? Because I'm not really mic'd up here. I just have my little microphone right here. By the way, link in the description if you want to check out Nag's guitars. Reverb actually has a ton of them. So I did put a link right in the description, which goes right to it, sorted by dollar amount. So did the sorting for you. So we're listening to the Black Widow right there. So DR, thank you. I just backed the volume off a little bit. Can you tell me, does it sound a little better? it might be compressing across YouTube because it doesn't look like I'm clipping here. Only for a few seconds, then it compresses. It might have to do with the setting on here. Yeah, I don't think I could change it. I'm actually using YouTube Studio Live, and I don't think there's a way for me to turn off the, then the volume goes down. It goes underwater. Yep. Yeah. I think that's because I can't turn off. You don't have a lot of options in YouTube Studio, unfortunately. Let me see something here. Pop out chat. So if I take that off, no, I don't have any options to actually to change the audio. My apologies. And I don't want to mess with it again. Let me see something here. If I click over here. Yep. Yeah, it sounds like that's what happens when there's audio processing. So my apologies. I should have used StreamYard for this, and I didn't because I could disable audio processing. I didn't even think about that, so my apologies. I could give you a little excerpt so you could hear. That should probably come out okay. I'll give you little bits and pieces. Gary Davlin says, do you know who their designer is? Nags all have a look about them that appeals to me. I actually think it's Joe Nags. That's one of the reasons why he started his own company, was he wanted to take his guitars and his designs to market. All good. Just play it and have fun. Thank you. Metal makes me crazy. Let me do something also. Just bear with me one second. I just want to check something here. Just bear with me. Talk amongst yourselves for a sec. I'm not looking at the screen. Just hang tight. Just give me a second. My apologies. I'm looking for something here. Okay, here it is. Okay. Okay, I'm back. My apologies. Ken Rogers says, I got an early 80s Wasp sound. Hold on. How about this one? Something like that. You know what that one is? Little Blind in Texas. Uh-huh. What's the other one? Hold on. Let me look this one up real quick. I can't say it. I can't say it by name. It would be wrong of me. Oh, here we go. Jose Benito Martinez Jr., thank you so much. And there you go. Thank you, Jose. I appreciate that. So, if we play a little Name That Tune, and again, I apologize for the underwater stuff. Here we go. Go ahead, sing it to yourself. I used to have that song on my wake up alarm, and my wife was like, WTF, oh, I'm clipping, okay. J77, thank you. I appreciate that. But anyway, this is a guitar, just a beautiful guitar. Really nice. And you know what? Sometimes it's nice to plug into something different. And I'll do a full review on this too. So you get the full review. That headstock. Isn't that nice? Okay, let me show you what else is in the case. I gotta tell you, the guitar plays outstanding. It feels really great. And it's not too heavy. Beautiful guitar. What's my favorite amp in that room? That's a tough one. That's a tough one to answer, to be honest with you. Okay, let's see what we have in here. Okay, so we have a nice lanyard. Okay, we get a lanyard. We have your gear was cleaned and protected by Music Nomad. Okay. Oh, here we go. Here's the build sheet. And by the way, we have a pin, a couple of Allen keys, a truss rod. Excuse me, not a truss rod. A trem arm, Dunlop strap locks. Looks like a warranty card. Nice little baggie of goodness. Okay, so here we go. This one here is the build sheet. So you got that right there. What we have here is Ferrari red black. Body is alder. Neckwood is maple, ebony with dots. Headstock veneer is maple. It says Mourn ST. I don't know what that means. No pick guard. Hardware plating is black nickel. Tuners are Goto. Nut is graphite. Strap buttons are Dunlop. The electronics are volume, push-pull on the tone, three-way. Pickups are Seymour Duncan TB4 SH2N. Can someone look up the TB4? What's the TB4 and the SH2N? I think one is maybe the Jazz and the other one is the JB, if I'm not mistaken. TB4 SH2N. 7.8 pounds, strung up with 10 to 46. Signed by Mr. Nags. So that's the build sheet right there on this bad boy. Grumpy Mike, hello. How are you? TB4's Trembucker. Okay. And how about the SH2N? Which one is that one? Slim Picks. So there it is. Is that a hot rod set? Oh, that is the Jazz. Gizmo Gadget in the house. So that's the Jazz. So Jazz, a Trembucker, and a Jazz. There you go. It's a beautiful guitar. It really is. Try to get the light so you could see the actual shape of the headstock. Let's do my thumbnail picture real quick. Hold on. I'm going to put this in here. That didn't work. Hold on. Do that. Do this. I'm posing for the thumbnail for the video. You ready? Hold on. There we go. Actually, I should hold it up a little bit more, get the whole guitar. So we got that. Bring it in a little bit. That's how we make thumbnails. It's funny, sometimes at the end of videos, I'll literally just like an idiot have the camera rolling and I'm like this. You know, all these, and then you take the still from the video. You do all these little poses, which is kind of funny. Chris Southen, hello. It is. It's a very high quality guitar. It feels really nice. It's a nice feeling guitar. Not too heavy. The neck, I think the magic here is actually this neck feels really good. And, you know, it's just, it's a nice guitar. It's a beautiful guitar. I like the black chrome. So you could kind of see how you have the chrome saddles with the black, plate. It's a nice guitar. Everything about it, the case, the whole experience, it's beautiful. Nags. You know, it's funny that they call that Ferrari red. To me, Ferrari red is more orange. That looks more like I don't want to say a blood red, but more of a blood color than a Ferrari red color. I always thought Ferrari red had an orange tint. That doesn't really have an orange tint. That's more like a darker red. The tuners are locking Goto, which look like a traditional Klusen with the locking screw on the back. Yeah, Joshua says, love the flame neck. Reminds me of a violin or a mando. Yep. Fiesta Red has more like, when I think of, yeah, maybe like a Fiesta Red. In fact, hold on, because I know it's hard to, let me give you a link. I'll show you exactly what it looks like. Just bear with me 1 second. This way you could see it on your computer monitor without all the stuff in my background. Okay, bear with me. Hold on. Don't go anywhere. I'm just looking for So here is a link I'm going to put across the stream. And if you look at that guitar, that's the same red that's on this guitar. And you tell me what kind of red. Now, it's not exactly it's actually the inverse of my guitar. I have the red top with the black bevel. This has the black guitar with the red bevel. But if you look at the red, especially like if you look at the back picture on this guitar, like you could scroll through the pictures, you could see, everything guitar, I agree with you. Fiesta Red more looks like Campbell Soup Red. That's not Campbell Soup Red. Rock Maple, yep. So what would you call, so I sent you the link. What would you call that red? See, for me, Ferrari Red was always, let me see. I'm Googling Ferrari Red. You know what? This might be Ferrari Red. No, that is Ferrari Red. No, it is Ferrari Red. I'm looking at Ferrari Red. What red am I thinking about? There's another color. What's that color called? There's a different Ferrari that looks more, different Ferrari color that looks more orange. So I take it back. That's definitely Ferrari Red. Because if you Google Ferrari Red, that's that color. DR says Ferrari looks a little brighter. Winston, I am GMT minus 5, EDT. That's my time zone. Does it come in John Deere green? That's funny. Probably. They're a custom shop. They'll build whatever you want. Indian red. That's interesting. Yeah, I would say that's definitely like an Indian red. I tell you, it's a beautiful red. Whatever it is, they call it Ferrari red, and it might be. I'm thinking of Ferrari. Yeah, I guess that is Ferrari red. I always thought Ferrari had a little bit more orange to it, but apparently I must be thinking of something else. Let me see what color this is here. But it's definitely Ferrari red for sure. So, Dakota red. It's definitely darker in the picture. I agree. Yep. So, anyway, folks, that is all I have for you today. I did put out a couple of videos this past week. I did the jewelry video, which, interestingly enough, a lot of people. Like I did right up front, I had said, you know, if this is your thing, you might want to check it out. But I did tell a story in there about, you know, kind of my personal experience with that. Ethical Ariel, what's the news? It's important. This is going to be good. Oh, maybe I'm thinking of Porsche, right? Okay. I don't know. I know one of the sports cars has, I know one of the sports, cars has a more orange color anyway. So, I was saying before I got sidetracked from the comments that I'm reading here. And, did some videos. I did the jewelry video. I did the, what was the other? I did the PRS video, which, I really enjoyed. And, actually the clean sound on that came out outstanding. And I used a room mic for that, the clean sound. So if you want to hear clean, you gotta see, it's the one I just released yesterday. Yesterday, outstanding. And of course I used a backing track so you could see what it looks like in the mix. That was a lot of fun. Oh, Ian ordered the wireless system you showed the other day. Oh, and that was it, right? The wireless. You know, I'm happy I did that video. You know, you have to bear in mind I am very influenced by the comments, what you guys tell me, and gals, guys and gals tell me. And I also try to share with you my honest to goodness approach on things. I was like, another wireless unit. But then when I looked at it and saw the features, it had the battery thing. It had the 1 into 4 or 4 into 1, and it was a good price. I'm like, you know what? Maybe there's value there. Right. So, and people were very thankful. They were like, no, this is great. So, it sounds like I hit the mark there. John Doe says, do you use Windows base or OS X operating system? I actually use both. I use both. I have to find a Ferrari and take a pic of the guitar laying on it. Okay. I don't know anyone that owns a Ferrari. I mean, that's not my my circle of friends don't own Ferraris. But if I ever see a Ferrari parked in front of my house, I will go take that picture. It just might not happen in my lifetime. Charvel Shredder, ooh, I like your question. If I had to choose between a CE or an S2, that's a good question. I would say it depends on what you're after, because I like both. Okay, like for instance, the 594 doesn't come in a CE, so if that's your thing, it's an S2. But I love why am I drawing a blank? That one right over there with the maple fretboard. Whose signature guitar is that? Somebody please remind me. That guitar is a beast. So it depends what you're after. I would say Dusty Waring. Thank you, DR. You know, that's a problem when you can't remember the freaking guitars that you have. Thank you, DR. And DR, hopefully I'll see you tomorrow night. Reminder, friendly reminder. That Dusty, I got to tell you, well, you know what's interesting? I own a lot of PRS guitars. Not a ton. I wouldn't say I own 100 of them, but I own a few. And I would have to say, just in terms of pure beauty, that 594, I think, is on top. That's a gorgeous guitar. And in terms of just raw playability, the Dusty Waring. So I'm right in the middle on S2 or 594. I think it comes down to what do you want in a guitar? Because I think they're a little different. That Dusty Waring is their version of a Jackson soloist, in my humble opinion. That's PRS's version of a Jackson. What you would see, hear, and feel in a Jackson, you know. Actually, no, I take that back. A Charvel. Because it's bolt-on. It's not like a neck through and all that stuff. So I take that back. That would be your USA-made Charvel. The Dusty Waring. That's their hot rodded guitar. Even the pickups, they don't wind those pickups. Those are Mojo Tone Tomahawk pickups. Does it shred the neck wise? I don't remember. You'd have to check the spec. All I remember is it was wildly comfortable. Jose says, I would say it's more like a GM color that was assigned to the 1962 Chevrolet Corvette Honduras Maroon. Look at the paint chip for those GM colors. Okay, I will check that out. J77 says, what is your holy grail guitar? You know, I would say the guitars that I really like are, you know, it's the usual suspects. Let me turn around and look behind me, right? I think the Kiesel guitars are great. Okay. I think I have a warm spot in my heart for Charvel Jackson. I grew up with that brand. Kramer, I like ESP. I like a lot. PRS. The Framus guitars are outstanding, right? So I would say the Holy Grail guitar, see, that's tough. I don't know what the Holy Grail guitar would be, but I would say, you know, if you think, well, let's put it like this. Let me answer the question this way. Thank you, DR. I appreciate that. I would say this. There's hundreds of guitar brands, okay? I have about 10 favorites. And I said it like that because I don't want to give the impression that I like everything, because I don't like everything. Just to be clear, Krellbar says, do you have a Sur? I do have a Sur. I think I used a Sur. Oh, no, I was going to use a Sur in another video, and I didn't. I do have a Sur. So I'm waiting for the next question. The next one's an obvious one. I'll wait for Krellbar to ask the question. So while I'm waiting for Krellbar to ask me the next question, the reason why I said I like 10 guitars and I compared it to 100 is I don't like everything, okay? But the stuff I like, I really like. So Krellbar, I thought your question was going to be, so which one do you like better, the Nags or the Sur? That's the question I thought was coming next. There you go, Brian from Oregon, on cue. That's the question. I thought that was the follow-up. Well, so I don't have the Sur in front of me, okay? But I'll tell you this. The top on the Sur is gorgeous. This is a painted top. So it's comparing apples to oranges, okay? But the feel, this guitar, honest to goodness. Like the neck, my neck is not like this on the Sur. The neck on my Sur is like the neck on the back of my Warren D. Martini Charvel. It's a matte finish maple neck. This is wonderful. But that's my Sur. Now, apples to apples, I would have to have two similar guitars, which I don't. The top on my Sur is stunning. Probably one of the nicest tops I've ever seen on a Sur. And that was a limited edition guitar that I bought at Chuck Levin's. I forget what the finish was, but it's just gorgeous. But I would say blindfolded, if I had to feel both, this one. So hopefully that answers the question I was waiting for. See, this to me, I would put this under the category of a badass guitar. This is a badass guitar. So you have to remember, let's put it like this, right? You take Steve Stevens as an example. I don't really talk about Steve Stevens, but Steve Stevens, I have a lot of respect for Steve Stevens. First of all, I have a lot of respect for him as a musician because, you know, he and Billy Idol wrote outstanding songs, right? There's a lot of great musicians that can't write a hit song. He's very smart. Shaky Mike says he's a fraud. I'd be curious to know why, because let me tell you what I do know about Steve Stevens. Yeah, thank you, DR Guitars. He's a badass. I think he you know, guy's a rock star, right? You know, go watch. Listen, you want me to change your opinion about Steve Stevens if you're not a Steve Stevens fan? Go watch the Rig Rundown. That guy is hands on. Okay, he knows his gear. He knows how to play his gear. You know, there's a lot of players that are very detached. You know, they're just good musicians, but they don't know crap about their gear, their guitars, their amps, their rigs. They pay people to do that. Okay. Some of the guitarists in the top of the triangle, not Eddie Van Halen. I think Eddie Van Halen is very in tune with his gear, but the other people that are in the top of the triangle, I don't think they, I think they might claim to know a lot, but I don't think they know a lot about their gear. I'm not saying names for obvious reasons. I don't want to upset anyone, but I've heard too many stories. But anyway, I'm not here to spread rumors. But Steve Stevens, guy's the real deal. I've seen over and over and over again consistently that the guy knows how to play. The guy knows his gear. He's passionate about his gear. The guy's a rock star, you know. And he's from New York, so... I am not talking about Brian May from Queen. Not at all. I have a lot of respect for Steve. So what I'm saying is Steve Stevens could play whatever he wants to play, and he plays a Nags. And, you know, when I look at that guitar, when I play that guitar, when I hold that guitar, I think that's a guitar that, you know, that's a guitar that belongs on stage. Charvel said, Shredder says, Steve Stevens is no fraud. Listen to him play flamenco. I was actually shocked that someone said he's a fraud. Like, give me context, because that, I was shocked, really. I don't think I've seen a bad video with Steve Stevens. His home studio looks like my own. This is a little ridiculous, I know, but it's my gig, right? But the guy is just plugged in to what he does. He embraces what he does. I think he's the same guy on camera as off camera. I think he's the same guy on stage as he is off stage. You know, he's the real deal. You know, I think, you know, and listen, and when I say a rock star, you know, he was doing MIDI stuff before a lot of people were doing MIDI with some of the effects. You know, he was like a pioneer with some of that stuff. You know, and listen, it's the guy gets dressed up for the occasion, right? You know, he puts on a show. You have to remember, to play music is to entertain yourself, your audience. We're in the entertainment business. You know, he does an outstanding job of entertaining. So anyway, that's my two cents on Steve Stevens. Want to sell the Jubilee? I don't want to sell the Jubilee. I'm sorry. Someday it'll be for sale. My wife's going to wind up selling all this stuff someday. So this is how it's going to go down. I'm going to die someday, and my wife's going to reach out to a couple of people that are named on my guitar list, and they're probably going to do a video saying, hey, here's the auction. Here's the list, right? That's how that's going to go down. Hopefully it doesn't happen for another 40 years or more, but that's how that's going to go. But right now I'm going to hang on to the Silver Jubilee. Yeah, Krellbar. I thank you. You know what, Krellbar? Hang on. Let's do this. I got Krellbar, DR. There you go. Leather pants and the wheel. Thank you, DR. Yeah. So anyway, folks, that's it. I hope this weekend, hold on, Alexa, what's the weather this weekend?
Here's the weather in Englishtown for this weekend. Saturday, 78 degrees Fahrenheit and partly sunny weather. Sunday, 67 degrees and lots of clouds.
Okay, there you go. Nice weekend. So, folks, I hope you all have... I'm reading the comments. I'm shaking my head. I'm doing one of these. Oh, thank you, Aaron. Any Memorial Day sales come... By the way, listen, as always, if you have a question, ask the question. If I don't answer, ask again. And if it's personal, I just won't answer it. But you could ask anything that you want. So before we wrap up, I'll just say if anyone has a question, I'll hang on for a few minutes. Let me know. Who asked me about Memorial Day deals? I don't know. I don't know of any outstanding. I have not seen the deals. I'm sorry. I'm getting distracted by the comments. That's funny. Ian said you woke up my Alexa. Alexa, volume 10. Alexa, play music.
Here's a playlist you might like.
The 80s. Alexa, stop. I just trolled your Alexa. I'm sorry. What I was saying was where was I? My apologies. I haven't seen the deals. I haven't seen any outstanding deals yet. Like I said earlier, if you need shorts, a suit, dress shirts, buy it now. No joke. I was buying button down, cause like for the day job, I'll do a button down collared shirt. And, I was buying shirts for $20 that normally cost $60. It was insane. My son bought some stuff online at, I don't know, like Adidas sneakers and like whatever he buys and likes, dirt cheap. Clothes right now, really good prices. My wife has bought a couple of things. Cause again, they remember it's seasonal. They blow out the winter stuff, they bring the summer stuff, but let me tell you, everything's on sale. I haven't seen the same deals with guitars yet. And I don't know why. I get the emails every day, but when I click on them, there's nothing exciting in the email. So I don't know. Loose Cannon says, do you think companies will reevaluate its business interest from overseas and look at other overseas countries to manufacture their imports? I do. I actually do. I think yes. Yes is the short answer. Yeah, I do. Thank you, Dior. I appreciate it. Indonesia, I would say. So Chris says, do my kids play? My daughter is the musician. Yeah, someone is bored tonight. But Krellbar and DR, thank you both. I appreciate it. What was the other question? I think Indonesia is the new Korea, believe it or not. And if what I was told was correct, the Korean factories own the Indonesian factories. So you're getting the quality control. I don't think I've played a bad Indonesian guitar. And I say that generally speaking. I don't think there's, I don't think an Indonesian guitar compares to like the Nags as an example. Are you talking a handcrafted, guy that actually designed the guitar versus someone that's just making the guitars, right? But if you're looking for a $500 to $800 guitar, I have no problems with an Indonesian guitar at all. I have to be honest with you. I'm not a fan of guitars that come out of China. It has nothing to do with politics. It's just the guitars that have come out of China were okay. Korea, better. Indonesia, probably as good as Korea. The only exception I would put in there are the acoustic guitars that come out of China, because they are a market known for making acoustic guitars. I own several acoustic guitars that are made in China, no problems. And Gibson has, I think, their own factory in China. And their new Epiphones rocked. And I think those are Chinese. So there's always exceptions to the rules. Always exceptions. Aaron Cram said, you aren't happy with your D'Angelico. Yeah, I wasn't. That was, I love the guitar. Don't get me wrong. I had my eye on that guitar for 3 or 4 years. Never touched it. Never played it. Never picked it up. I'm kind of messed up like that. I will buy a guitar sight unseen. And I will know if I want a guitar. Because you have to remember, I look at guitars like artwork. Kind of, sort of. I appreciate the art that goes into the instrument. I like that as much as the music, to be honest with you all. So I will buy a guitar without ever picking it up or playing it or that type of thing. If I like it, I'll buy it. When I got the D'Angelico, I love the guitar, but for some reason I didn't gel with the guitar. And I don't know. I don't know what it was. And it was, you know what it was? I think that was probably the biggest guitar that I had. Like, I felt like this when I was playing it, you know? And the look, I think it looks better at a distance than it did in person. Like, listen, it was a nice guitar. It had the nice flame. I liked the headstock. I don't know what it was. I didn't gel with the guitar. I don't know. I don't know. Just wasn't, you know, which guitar I did gel with is my, from a semi hollow, like the Framus television, that's a semi hollow, but it's, if you know, you, again, you're dealing with a high quality, just looks, feels, plays outstanding. Even my Chinese made Epiphone Wildcat, it's kind of a cool guitar, but it's comfortable. Yeah, Brian, I think you're right. I'm not a 335 guy. I think, Brian, I think you nailed it. All these words that are coming out of my mouth, you just summarized in five words, four words. I don't think I'm a 335 guy. I think that's what it comes down to. Because you have to remember, you want to, even the guitars I own that I don't play, you want to love what you own. And I love the guitar when I didn't own it. But owning it, I wasn't in love with it. So I let it go. And man, I, you know, remember when I did that and said, guys, listen, when I tell people to go buy something because the price is good and it won't last, I usually mean that. That sold out like right after I did that video. And then people were price gouging. People were selling them for, you know, I think, what was that guitar? $500? It was originally like 1200, something like that. So it was more than half, 60% off, whatever that is. And, people were selling them on Reverb and eBay for $700-$800. And I put mine on for exactly what I paid. In fact, maybe I added $50 just to cover like the shipping. And the guy that bought it was thrilled to pieces. It sold in 30 seconds. 'Cause again, I wasn't looking to make a killing on it. I just, you know, sometimes I try to make a killing, you know, if I have a guitar that's 15 years old and it's the only one on earth, yeah, I'm going to try to get more for that. But that wasn't my goal with that guitar. My goal was, hey, listen, I got a good deal. I paid it forward. I gave someone else a good deal on it. You know, it all depends on the guitar. That's the buying, selling conversation. Different motivations in terms of how you buy and sell things. Spend the green to get the green. Yeah, there you go. So, DR, are you sure it's not Korean? I thought the SM1s were Korean made. You sure about that? Maybe the new ones are made in Indonesia. J77 says, I do animal rescue. I saved or transported over 500 dogs in the last 4 years. It means a lot. Wow. Well, J77, as an animal lover myself and as the parent of many pets that I love to pieces, that's nice to hear. So thank you. And keep helping animals if you can. You know what I've had a lot of over here? Foxes. Get a lot of foxes at night. And so we have a little dog. Max is the little hot dog. He's a dachshund. And, you know, foxes will prey on a little dog. And Max will just roll on his back. And so now at night, when the dogs want to go out, my wife or I will send Rosie out with Max. Rosie's the German Shepherd. And if you don't know what Rosie looks like, go to my Instagram page. Someone called her a land shark, which I thought was kind of funny. I need to put up a quick little video of her personality on my Instagram. She is she's great with the family, but she is a no-nonsense dog with anything that's not the family. Very, what do you call that, territorial. I love her to pieces, but man, if I didn't know her, I don't know if I'd be loving her to pieces. She's a pretty aggressive dog. She's a year old, 90 pounds, and she knows how to cuddle and hang out and be all mushy with you and, you know, do what dogs do best, you know, lay next to you and cuddle with you and want to play and be pet. But when I walk her and there's a stranger across the street, she wants to tear him apart, which is kind of funny. Little Jekyll and Hyde going on. But when I tell her to sit, she sits. She's very smart. Probably the smartest dog I've ever owned. Very smart. But yeah, Dan of NJ, very protective. I remember when Jerry from Petal Pods came over and I told him, I said, listen, we have a, yeah, you have coyotes. I said, just so you know, I have a very aggressive dog. He's like, I love dogs. I'm like, all right. So I put her on the leash. I try to introduce her to people outside so she doesn't feel, you know, cornered in, right, like in that front door area. And I brought her out, and he was like, whoa, yeah, maybe we want to put her away. you know, even on the leash, she'll stand up on both back paws and just, you know, foam at the mouth at you. Yeah, Ian, I put a lot of cool stuff on Instagram. I don't do it to grow my Instagram. I don't really. I just do it for you guys. Just so, you know, between videos, I take a couple of pictures of maybe what's coming or some non-related Tone King stuff. Pictures of the dog and the yard and the cars and just, you know, personal life stuff. So if you want a little behind the scenes, Instagram is always a good place to follow me on. And oftentimes I'll follow you back if, you know, you got, like, if you have stuff up there and you're looking to share and all that. So, my Instagram is just the Tone King. So you'll see it up there. It's actually in the link in the description as well. So DR bobcats, that would scare me more. Bobcats, cougars, bobcats, they will, they have no fear. They'll attack you, me, right? They'll attack a person. I think like foxes, they'll go after a little dog. But like I've gone outside while there was a fox in the yard. They hear the door open, they take off. They're afraid. Bobcats and they have them in Jersey, up in North Jersey in the mountains. There's been sightings of that, and they won't back down. I mean, they're a predator. They'll attack a person. That scares me. Oh, you said bobcats, not too bad. Cougars and the Jags. Okay. I think in New Jersey, I don't know if it's the same thing. I'm no expert, but they call them mountain lions over here. Is that the same thing? The mountain lion? That's what we have over here is mountain lions. Luckily, there's not too many. But it shows up on the news once a year where, you know, go to YouTube if you haven't seen it and just type in jogger mountain lion. And sometimes a jogger is on a trail and they, like, you know, deer in the headlights, And then they just start walking backwards. And you could see, like, they'll have their cell phone or their GoPro, whatever. It's like sitting that, like, you know, like in a, I'm going to jump on you mode, like in the rocks on the side, blended in. Like, that's pretty scary. Oh, okay. So cougars are mountain lions. Okay. There you go. There are the old wolf here and there too. Yeah, we don't have wolves here. Coyotes aren't afraid of dogs, especially in packs. And coyotes and foxes are different, right? Is it like same family? You know what we have a lot of in New Jersey is, Johnny said a wild dog killed a doctor in Georgia. I didn't even know this such a thing as wild dogs today. I got to look that up in the news. Bear country. There's also black bears up in North Jersey. Not so much down where I'm at. Oh, foxes are small. Okay. You have wolves, Brian. Interesting. What was I saying? I totally got sidetracked. Oh, wild dogs. Yeah, Chris is like, guys, can we talk about guitars? Sorry. Domesticated dogs born in the wild will join coyote packs. That's interesting. All right, folks, we're way off the beaten path. So I want to thank you all for being here tonight. I appreciate it very much. All the links are in the description below. Come to Australia, everything will kill you. That's funny. But thank you all for being here. Hopefully you enjoyed hanging out. Hit the like, thumbs up on the way out. I think that's supposed to be good for me in the channel. So if you could do that, I don't know the dividend that it pays, but I would sure appreciate it. If you're new, welcome. Subscribe if you want to see more like it. And I, in true Tone King fashion, I'm going to leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there. Be safe and rock on. Thank you for being here, everyone. Take care. Thanks.